China's latest AI breakthrough has leapfrogged the world.
I think we should take the development out of China very, very seriously.
A game-changing move that does not come from OpenAI, Google, or Meta.
There is a new model that has all of the Valley buzzing.
But from a Chinese lab called DeepSeek.
For many years, the narrative in the AI world has been dominated by the United States. Companies like OpenAI, Google, and Microsoft seem to hold an unassailable lead, fueled by massive investments and cutting-edge research. The US government, confident in its lead, imposed export controls restricting China's access to advanced semiconductors, vital for training large AI models. The assumption was clear. These restrictions would keep China years behind. In the last days of his presidency, Joe Biden passed an even stricter law, splitting the world into three tiers. Tier 1 countries can have access to the latest US semiconductors. Tier 2 countries can have limited access. And Tier 3 countries like Iran, Russia, China are banned from their technology altogether. Then, on the 20th of January, the same day as the inauguration of Donald Trump, the 47th president of the USA, a world-changing announcement was made by an almost unknown Chinese company, DeepSeek, announcing their AI large language model DeepSeek R1. Make no mistake, this announcement on the same day as Donald Trump's inauguration was 100% intentional. China was sending a strong message to the new US president that the chip and technology sanctions of the previous Biden administration had failed to stop China's AI development. DeepSeek R1, developed by the Chinese AI lab DeepSeek, is not just another AI model, it's a game changer. This open source reasoning model has demonstrated performance comparable to OpenAI's latest models, but at a fraction of the cost. This is not simply a marginal improvement. It represents a paradigm shift in how we think about AI development and deployment. The key to DeepSeek R1's success lies in its innovative training approach. Unlike models that rely heavily on supervised fine-tuning, DeepSeek R1 uses a unique combination of reinforcement learning and carefully curated data. This allows the model to develop sophisticated reasoning skills, including chain-of-thought reasoning, where it breaks down complex problems, and self-verification, where it evaluates its own outputs. This means that it performs equal to or better than the leading models from Google, OpenAI, and Meta on many benchmark metrics. But it's not just about the performance. The cost-effectiveness of DeepSeek R1 is remarkable. At just 14 cents per million tokens, it drastically undercuts the operational costs of many US-developed proprietary models. This affordability isn't just a marginal advantage, it's a game-changer, potentially democratizing access to powerful AI technology for a wider audience. This has significant implications for US companies who face the prospect of having to compete with a highly capable, significantly cheaper alternative. The fact that DeepSeek R1 being open source is also a big deal, as it provides the ability for developers to optimize and deploy the model on their own infrastructure, further reducing costs and enabling smaller businesses and individual developers to participate in the AI revolution. This contrasts sharply with the proprietary approach of many US AI companies, potentially shifting the balance of power in the AI landscape by empowering a more diverse and inclusive AI ecosystem. The implications of DeepSeek R1 extend far beyond mere technological achievement. Its release is a stark reminder of the evolving dynamics of the China-USA AI technology race. The US, with its long-held lead in AI innovation, believed that its export controls on semiconductors would hinder China's progress. However, DeepSeek R1 demonstrates that these restrictions have been a complete failure. A little more than 6 months ago, in May 2024, Eric Schmidt, Google's ex-CEO and now a technology advisor, said China is struggling because of chips, particularly due to restrictions on importing high-speed chips like those from NVIDIA, which are essential for scaling AI.
In early 2024, former Google CEO Eric Schmidt, he predicted China was 2 to 3 years behind the US in AI. But now Schmidt is singing a different tune. Here he is on ABC's This Week.
Well, I used to think we were a couple of years ahead of China, but China has caught up in the last 6 months in a way that is remarkable. The fact of the matter is that a couple of the Chinese programs, one, for example, is called DeepSeek, looks like they've caught up.
The truth is that these very restrictions have had the opposite effect to what the US had intended. By pushing Chinese companies like DeepSeek to innovate further, focusing on efficiency and algorithmic advantages due to not having access to the latest NVIDIA GPUs. Let's listen to what the CEO of Perplexity has to say.
Okay, so first of all, China has a lot of disadvantages in competing with the US. Number one is the fact that they don't get access to all the hardware that we have access to here. So they're kind of working with lower end GPUs than us. And the fact that the bigger models tend to be more smarter naturally puts them at disadvantage. But the flip side of this is that necessity is the mother of invention. Because they had to go figure out workarounds, they actually ended up building something a lot more efficient. But that is likely to make them come up with a more efficient solution than America. And of course, they have open sourced it, so we can still adopt something like that here. But that kind of talent they're building to do that will become an edge for them over time, right?
The release of DeepSeek R1 has really shocked the USA AI industry. Shortly after the DeepSeek R1 announcement, Sam Altman of OpenAI said that paid users were going to get the O3 model. I suspect this was a direct response to the fact that DeepSeek is offered for free, and I suspect many ChatGPT users will be considering cancelling their $20 per month subscriptions. And a leaked document from Meta, who are also developing open source AI models, appeared online. The document read, "With DeepSeek version 3, which rendered the Llama 4 already behind in benchmarks, adding insult to injury was the unknown Chinese company with $5.5 million training budget. Engineers are moving frantically to dissect DeepSeek and copy anything and everything we can from it. I'm not even exaggerating. Management is worried about justifying the massive cost of GenAI org. How would they face the leadership when every single leader of GenAI org is making more than what it costs to train DeepSeek version 3 entirely? And we have dozens of such leaders. DeepSeek R1 made things even scarier. I can't reveal confidential info, but it'll soon be public anyways. It should have been an engineering-focused small organization, but since a bunch of people wanted to join the impact grab and artificially inflate hiring in the org, everyone loses." This is Meta admitting that even with their huge AI spending, they have been beaten by a little-known Chinese company with a small budget. A number of experts in the AI field commented on DeepSeek R1's significance. Dr. Sarah Chen from Stanford highlighted its cost-effectiveness and potential to democratize. Professor James Miller noticed its advanced search capabilities. And Mark Andreessen posted on X that DeepSeek R1 is AI's Sputnik moment. DeepSeek R1's release has shocked the US, proving that China's AI capabilities are far more advanced than previously thought, and that sanctions have completely failed. The model's cost effectiveness will disrupt the AI industry and challenge the existing pricing models of US companies. The open source nature of DeepSeek R1 also allows developers worldwide to contribute to the model's improvement and explore its applications, which will foster global innovation in the field. This is not just a technological advancement. It's a shift in the balance of power in the AI landscape and a sign of a more multipolar future for AI development. The DeepSeek R1 story is far from over, and its full impact will become clearer over the next months and years. However, its release is undoubtedly a pivotal moment in the AI industry. A dose of reality for the USA and a stark reminder. Never underestimate the Chinese people. Something I have said many, many times. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. However, as always, for now, take care.